Hello students, my name is G. Nikita, I'm pharmacy assistant professor in department of pharmaceutical chemistry. I will deal the medicinal chemistry 2 subject for B. Pharmacy 3rd year first semester. So today we are going to discuss about drugs acting on endocrine system. It is the 4th unit. So in this we will discuss the introduction of the steroids, means what are the steroids, its nomenclature, and what are the sex hormones and how many types are there, and the biosynthesis of the sex hormones, structure, synthesis of testosterone, estradiol, and estriol, diethyl, stilbestrol, and progesterone. So these are the contents we are going to discuss in this topic, that is introduction, nomenclature, sex hormones and biosynthesis of the sex hormones and structures, synthesis of testosterone, estradiol, estriol and diethyl, stilbestrol and progesterone. So introduction. So let's discuss that what are the steroids and its structure. So steroids are the unique class of the chemical compounds found widely in the animals and the plant kingdom. So these steroids can able to form in both plants and the animals. So they are characterized by the presence of 1,2 cyclopentano per hydrophenanthrene nucleus in the structure. So in the structure of the steroids, it has a 1,2 cyclopentano per hydrophenanthrene nucleus. See here, you see the structure of the steroids. So it is the 1,2 cyclopentano. So pentane structure is there per hydrophenanthrene. So phenanthrene means 1, 2, 3. This 3-6 membered ring combined is known as A, B, C. So these are the 6 membered ring. So this 3-6 membered ring is the phenanthrene, and 1-5 membered ring is there. It is the pentane. So this is the structure of the steroids, and it includes the variety of the naturally occurring synthetic compounds such as sterols, bile acid, sex hormones, adrenal cortical and contraceptive drugs, cardiac active lactones, and certain alkaloids and antibiotics. So the term cholesterol is derived from the Greek word. So cholesterol word is the Greek word bile, which means coal, and solid, which means steroids. So the modern era steroid research began with the steroid chemistry. So the research has been begin with the steroid chemistry, which has been started in the 1900. So the Dr. A.O. Windows, he is a person name is Dr. A.O. Windows, has been worked for 20 years on this method. So has worked for 20 years, and for this process he got the Nobel Prize in 1948. So he has did the research in the steroids for the 20 years, and he got the Nobel Prize in 1928. And Dr. Henrich and Whelan, they have done the experiment on the natural product chemistry, which is including the bile acids. And so they also got the Nobel Prize in 1928. And also the 6 Nobel Prizes were awarded to the scientists, those who are working on the steroids area. Among them, 4 have got the Nobel Prize in steroid chemistry category. The Prenor work of the Aldolf, Windows and Henrich in the structure elucidation of the number important steroids led to many discoveries in the world of the steroids. So this is the introduction of the steroids. I will explain it again. So steroids, it is the unique class of the chemical compound which is mainly found in the animals and the plants. So it is characterized by the presence of the 1,2 cyclopentano. This is pentane, pentano per hydrophenanthrene nucleus in the structure. So it can be naturally formed occurring in the synthetic substances like contraceptives, sex hormones, adrenal cortical, sterols, bile acids, and cardioactive lactones, certain alkaloids, and antibiotics. So it is a Greek word. Cholesterol is the Greek word from which bile is the coal and solid means the sterol. So cholesterol. So bile, solid is the cholesterol. So this means what will happen here. This experiment research has been done based upon the steroids chemistry or in the 1900. This research has been done by the Dr. A. O. Windows. So he had worked for 20 years on the steroids and he got the Nobel Prize in 1928. And next, Hendrich and Wieland, they have been done the research on the natural products chemistry, including the bile acid. And also, they also awarded the Nobel Prize in 1928. And another 6 Nobel Prizes were awarded to the scientists who were working on the steroids. So among the 6, 4 have got the award for the steroid chemistry category. So after discovery of this steroids, the many other structure also came into the world. Next, 2 important discoveries mentioned in 1940s and 1950s have the dramatic effect not only on the steroids but also the total medicinal chemistry, pharmacology, and clinical studies of the steroid agonist and antagonist. So here, the discoveries affects not only on the steroids but also the research on the medicinal chemistry, pharmacology, and clinical studies of the steroids. So steroids, basically, they are solid in nature. It has a high melting point. So it will melt from 100 degrees centigrade to 250 degrees centigrade. So steroids, that does not soluble in water, only soluble in organic solvents like ethanol, acetone, and chloroform. So next, nomenclature. Let's discuss the nomenclature of the steroids. So steroids consists of the 4 fusidrines. Here 4 fusidrines are the A, B, C, D. These are the 4 fusidrine. Chemically they are hydrocarbons, that is cyclopentano per hydrophenanthrene. So in this structure, there will be the 1-5 membered ring. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5-membered ring is there. 5-membered ring means pentane. So it is in the cyclic form. So it is named as the cyclopentane. D ring is the cyclopentane and remaining ring, that is A, B, C. It is a 6-membered ring. So it is a phenanthrene. So here A, B, C is the phenanthrene rings and D is the cyclopentane. And the earlier the various steroids are used to call with their common names like cholesterol and progesterone, testosterone. But later upon the development, the IUPAC nomenclature was used. So before the common name has been used, after the development, the IUPAC nomenclature has been preferred. So next, the steroid contains 17 carbon atoms and numbering the remaining carbon of phenanthrene allowed by numbering the remaining carbons of cyclopentane. Here, how we have can number the structures? First, we should give the numbering for the phenanthrene structure. 1, 2, 3 are there. No, first we have to give the numbering for phenanthrene, then cyclopentane, then followed by the other substituents. Like if here methyl groups are there. And here in the 17th position, if we have any other substitutions will come, no? Rather, we have to give the numbering for it. So first, we have to give the numbering for phenanthrene, then pentane structure, then followed by remaining substituents. So if any unsaturation is present in the steroids, so if it is A means it is a saturated form. Means single bond. If ene is present, means if one ene means presence of the double bond in the structure. So if one double bond is there, means ene. If two double bonds are there, means diene. three double bonds are there means triene. So if the double bond is not present in the carbon, it is named as a cell. It does not change its name. So if the steroids contain three membered ring, it is indicated by prefix cyclo. So if it is in the cyclic form, it is the cyclo, which is preceded by the number of positions concerned. Any enlargement of the steroid ring is indicated by prefix homo, and which is preceded by small capital indicating the ring affected. So the circles, if you see the structure, sometimes there may be the circles with the circles are there. So it indicates the alpha hydrogen, and if the dark dots are there, no, it is the beta hydrogen. The based upon the following important suffix for the stem name, we can do like this. First one is carboxylic acid, followed by carbonyl, followed by alcohol, amine, and ether. So it is the nomenclature of the steroids. I will explain it again. So if you see the structure, it has a four fused rings, that is A, B, C, D. It is a four fused ring. D is the cyclopentene, and ABC is the phenylalanine ring. In earlier days, this structure used to give the common names like cholesterol, progesterone, and testosterone. After going on development, diupack name has been preferred. So if we give the number, first we have to give the numbering for the phenylalanine structure, ABC. Phenylalanine structure, then followed by the pentane. After the completion of the pentane, if any of the substituents are there, means then next preference goes to the substituents. So if any of the unsaturation is there, means presence of the one double bond is E, two double bond means diene, and three double bond means triene is present. If any of the bond is not there, means there is no name, there is no change of the name of the structure. So if the steroids contains three membered ring, it is indicated by the prefix cyclo and proceed by the number of positions should be considered. An enlargement of the steroid ring is indicated by the prefix homo, proceed by the small capital indicating the ring affected. So if the circles are there, means in the structure it is used to indicate alpha hydrogens, and if the dark dots are there, means it is the beta hydrogens. Next, we can able to give the preference, first goes to the carboxylic acid, carbonyl, alcohol, amine, and ether. So this is the nomenclature of the steroids. Let's discuss about the six hormones. So these are the organic substances which are secreted by the endocrine glands, that is in our body. So it gets secreted in our body by the endocrine glands. So they will go to the different organs of the body by the bloodstream. So in by using the blood, it get means it get distributed to the different organs of the body to produce various physiological functions. So if there is any of the deficiency of the hormone in our body, means there will be the disease can be cured by administration of the hormones. So the hormones are basically produced in our body by the endocrine gland. So it will distribute throughout the body. So it will distribute it all over our body by using the blood to perform the function. So if there is a deficiency of the hormone is there, no, at that time there will be the disease, and means there will be the any of the problem in our body when the hormone is not released. In order to cure the disease, we have to administer hormone. So let's see the classification of the steroids, or divided into two sex hormones, that is male and the female, and adrenal cortical hormones. See here, hormones is divided into the steroids and non-steroids, two types. Hormones are steroids and non-steroids, And the steroids are divided into sex hormones and adrenal cortical hormones. See here, sex hormones and adrenal cortical hormones. The sex hormones has been divided into female sex hormones and male sex hormones. This female sex hormones has been divided into estrogen and gestrogen. So this is the classification of the hormones. That is, hormones is divided into steroids and non-steroids. The steroids has been divided into the sex hormones and adrenal cortical hormones, and the sex hormones has been divided into the female sex hormones and male sex hormones, and this female sex hormones has been divided into estrogen and gestrogen. So sex hormones are produced in the gonads, testes in the male, and the ovaries in the female. So this total has been stimulated by the pituitary gland. Next, biosynthesis of the sex hormones. So it has been started from the cholesterol. This is the structure of the cholesterol in the presence of side chain cleavage. So here we will get the pregnenolone. If you see the structure of the cholesterol and pregnenolone, here one of the side chain is there. No, here the side chain undergoes the cleavage, means cut down, means or the separation from this structure. So this side chain will undergoes the cleavage to form the pregnenolone in the presence of 17-alpha-hydroxylase. Presence of 17-alpha-hydroxylase, we will get 17-alpha-hydroxypregnenolone. Means here in the 17th position, the hydroxy group is attached here. So it is the 17-alpha-hydroxypregnenolone. Here in presence of 5-in-3-beta-hydroxysteroid, dehydrogenase, 3-oxosteroid, 4,5-isomerase, we will get progesterone. Structure. So if you see the structure of the pregnenolone and the progesterone, here in the third position in the pregnenolone, hydroxy group is there. But here in the progesterone, in place of the hydroxy group, the oxygen group is attached here. Here hydroxy group and here oxygen group is attached here. Next, in presence of 17,20 lyase, we will get the dihydro epinephrosteroid. So we will get dehydroepinephrosteroid we will get. So if you see here this 17-alpha-hydroxypregnenolone, from here one of the methyl group will get eliminated. Here the methyl group will get eliminated, and to get dihydroepinephrosteroid. So in and this is converted to androstenedione. So if we see the structure here, in third position there will be the hydroxyl group, but it is hydroxyl group is replaced with the oxygen group here in the third position. So in when it undergoes the aromatase, we will get the estrone. So here again, what will happen here in the third position, double bond oxygen is there, so it is replaced with the hydroxyl group. And also here in the fifth position, the double bond is removed, and here first, third and the fourth position, the double bond will be there. And here in the presence of the 17-beta-hydroxysteroid hydrogenase, 17-beta-hydroxysteroid hydrogenase, we will get the testosterone. Next, in presence of 5-alpha reductase, we will get 5-alpha hydrotestosterone. Next, that this testosterone in presence of the aromatase and also testosterone in presence of the undergoes the aromatase, we will get estradiol. And also this estrone can also be converted to the estradiol in presence of the estradiol dehydrogenase. So this is the biosynthesis of the hormones. So I will explain it again. the starting material is cholesterol. When the side chain undergoes the cleavage, here the side chain undergoes the cleavage to get the pregnenolone. In the presence of 17 alpha hydroxylase, we will get 17 alpha hydroxy pregnenolone. In presence of 5-3 beta hydroxysteroid dehydrogenase, 3-oxosteroid 4-5 isomerase, we will get progesterone. In presence of 17-20 lyase, we will get dehydroepiandrosterone. This is converted to androstenedione. So when it undergoes the aromatase, we will get estrone. This androstenedione, in the presence of 17-beta-hydroxysteroid hydrogenase, we will get testosterone. When it undergoes reacted with the 5-alpha reductase, we will get 5-alpha hydrotestosterone. When it undergoes the aromatase, when the testosterone undergoes the aromatase, we will get estradiol. And this estrone undergoes the estradiol dehydrogenase also, we will get estradiol. So this is the synthesis of the sex hormones. Let's discuss about the testosterone. So this is the structure and this is the IUPAC name. So IUPAC name is 17-hydroxy 10-13 dimethyl 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, and 17 dodecahydrocyclopentane phenanthrene 3-1. I will repeat it again. 17-hydroxy 10-13 dimethyl 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, and 17 dodecahydrocyclopentaphenanthrene 3-1. So if you see in the structure, this and this, 3 6 membered rings are there, no? It is a phenanthrene. This is the cyclopentane. 5 members are there, no? So it is the cyclopentane, phenanthrene, cyclopentane. So here for the phenanthrene, in the third position, oxygen is there. So phenanthrene 3-1. In 17th position, hydroxy is there. And here in the 10th and the 13th position, methyls are there. How many methyls? 2. So it is dimethyl. So it is named as 17-hydroxy 10-13 dimethyl cyclopentane phenanthrene 3-1. So it is the structure and IUPAC name of the testosterone. So it has been isolated from the testis. So synthesis. The starting material is the cholesterol. Here starting material is the cholesterol. In the presence of AC24 is the acetic anhydrous. So it is the acetic anhydride. And in presence of the bromine, we will get the cholesterol acetate dibromide. Cholesterol acetate dibromide. So here in the fifth and sixth position, the bromine is attached. Here in the third position, acetic anhydrous group is attached. See here in the third position, acetic anhydrous, and in fifth and sixth position, two bromine structures are attached. Next, in presence of chromium trioxide. See here, CrO3 is the chromium trioxide CrO3 is the chromium trioxide and CH3COOH is the acetic acid. So in presence of chromium trioxide and acetic acid, we will get the intermediate product. So here what will happen here, this is a side chain. Is there no here side chain undergoes the cleavage in the 17th position. So here in the 17th position, the double bond oxygen group is attached. In presence of when it undergoes the hydrolysis and zinc and acetic acid, we will get the another intermediate product. So here in the 17th position, in place of the double bond oxygen is replaced with the hydroxide group. And this dihydroepadosterone, so it is converted to the intermediate compound in presence of acetic anhydrase and ethanol. So this intermediate in the process, when it undergoes the hydrolysis process, in the presence of the benzoyl chloride and this in presence of the oxidizing agent, we will get here intermediate product. So here I have said no, here in the 17th position the hydroxy group is attached. So here in place of the hydroxyl group, this acetophenone has been attached. Next, here dihydroepadosterone upon oxidizing agent, we will get the androst 4-17-3-17-diol. So here in the fourth position, double bond is there. In third and the 17th position, two oxygens are there. So it is 3-17-diol. And this intermediate, when it undergoes the oxidation process, we will get the testosterone cypionate. So this androst 4-17-diol, we will get the testosterone. So this testosterone in presence of pyridine, we will get testosterone cypionate. And next here, the testosterone in presence of propanoyl chloride, we will get testosterone enanthate. And here the testosterone in presence of ethyl methyl ether, we will get testosterone propionate. I will repeat it again. The cholesterol in the presence of acetic anhydride and the bromine. So here in the third position, the acetic anhydrase will get attached. In the fifth and the sixth position, the bromine groups will get attached. So next, in presence of acetic acid and chromium trioxide, so here we will get the intermediate product. Here the side chain undergoes the cleavage. In the 17th position, the double bond oxygen will get attached. Next, here in the presence of zinc and acetic acid, when it undergoes the hydrolysis process, we will get the another intermediate compound. Here in the 17th position, the double bond O is replaced with hydroxyl group. Here, the dihydroepiandrosterone. So dihydroepiandrosterone. In the presence of acetic anhydrase and the ethanol and the sodium, the intermediate product we will get. This intermediate product in the presence of benzoyl chloride, here in the presence of oxidizing agent, we will get intermediate compound, and this is androst 4-17-diol. So when this intermediate undergoes the oxidation process, we will get testosterone cypionate, and this androst 4-17-diol is converted into the testosterone and this testosterone in presence of the pyridine, we will get testosterone cyanoate, and this in the presence of ethyl methyl ether, we will get testosterone propionate, and in the presence of propionyl chloride, we will get testosterone ethanoate. So this is the synthesis of the testosterone. So your properties and the uses: it is a creamy white crystalline powder. It is insoluble in water but soluble in alcohol, and it is used for the treatment of the breast carcinoma in postmenopausal women. Next, ostrione. This is the structure and this is the IUPAC name. IUPAC name is 13-methyl-6-7-8-9-11-12-14-15-16-17 decahydrocyclopentaphenanthrene-3-16-17 triol. I will repeat it again. 13-methyl-6-7-8-9-11-12-14-15-16-17 decahydrocyclopentaphenanthrene-3-16-17 triol. If you see the structure, this and this is the phenanthrene. 6-membered ring are there. 3 6-membered ring is the phenanthrene. 1 5-membered ring is there, that is pentane. So here in 13th position, methyl group is there. See here in 13th position, methyl, and here in the third, 16th and 17th position, 3 hydroxy groups are there. So it is triol. So here, 13-methyl-phenanthrene-cyclopentane 3-16-17 triol. So this is the structure and IUPAC name of ostriol. So it is isolated by the Marion from the urine of pregnant woman. So it is useful in some cases of the estrogen deficiency, especially for the relief of the menopausal symptoms. So it occurs mainly in the placenta and pregnant women. So next is synthesis. So it is starting material is starting material is the estrone in the presence of isopropanol acetate, we will get the intermediate product. See here in the third position and the 17th position. In the third position here hydroxyl group, and here in the 17th position oxygen group is there. So this two has been replaced by the acetyl group here in the intermediate. In presence of the benzoic acid, we will get the another intermediate compound. Here in the 17th position, the oxygen group is attached. Next, in presence of lithium aluminium hydrate, LiAlH4 is the lithium aluminium hydrate, we will get the ostriol. So here in place of the acetic anhydrous, the hydroxyl group is attached. See here in third and the 17th position. So I will repeat it again. The starting material is estrone. In presence of the isopropanol acetate, we will get intermediate product A. So here in the third position, hydroxyl group, and here in the 17th position, oxygen is there. So here it is replaced with the acetic anhydrous groups, and in presence of the benzoic acid, here in the 17th position and the 16th position, oxygen group is attached. In presence of lithium aluminium hydrate, we will get the osteol structure. So this is the synthesis. So next one is ostradiol. This is the structure, and this is the iopatin, methyl, tetracyclo, heptadeca, 1,3,5-triene, 3,17-diol. I will repeat it again. 13-methyl, tetracyclo, heptadeca, 1,3,5-triene, 3,17-diol. So if you see here, 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 cyclics are there. So 4 means tetra. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 means tetracyclo. In 13th position, methyl group is there. In 1, 3 and 5. How many double bonds are there? 3. 3 double bonds means triene. In 3rd position and 17th position, 2 hydroxyl groups are there. So it is diol. So here, 13, methyl, 1, 2, 3, 4. Tetracyclo, 1, 3, 5. Triene, 3,17-diol. So this is the structure and IUPAC name. So it can be exhibits in two forms, that is alpha form and beta form. But if we see, if we compare the alpha and the beta form is more active when we compare with the alpha form. So next is synthesis. So it is the starting material is osteol in presence of aluminium isopropoxide and also aluminium hydrate. Lithium aluminium hydrate and aluminium isopropoxide, we get ostradiol structure. So the difference between the osteol and the ostradiol structure is nothing but in the 17th position, here oxygen is there, but here in the 17th position the hydroxyl group is present. So that is only the difference. Here the starting material is osteol in presence of lithium aluminium hydrate and aluminium isopropoxide, we will get ostradiol structure. So this is the synthesis. Next, diethyl stilbestrol. So this is the structure and this is the IUPAC name. That is 4,4, 1,2 diethyl, 1,2 ethane diethyl, and this phenol. I will repeat it again. 4,4 phenol, 1,2 diethyl, 1,2 ethane diethyl, and this phenol. This phenol means here 2 phenol groups are there. So it is this phenol in the 4th position. Here one phenyl in the 4th position, another phenyl in the 4th position. We have the ethyl group. See here, 1, 2 carbon atoms with double bond is there. So ethane diene in first and the second position, the ethyl groups are there. C2H5. So it is 1,2 diethyl. So I will explain it again. 4,4, 1,2 diethyl. And 1,2 ethane diethyl, and this phenol. So this is the structure and IUPAC name of the compound. Next is synthesis. So it has been synthesized from the anisaldehyde. So it is also named as the DOTS method. So first method is the DOTS method. The starting material is the 4-methoxybenzaldehyde. In presence of potassium cyanide, we will get anisoene. So here, when the anisoene in presence of tin chloride, we will get deoxyanisoene. So here, if you see the anisoene structure here, one of the benzene ring. For this benzene here, methoxy group and aldehyde group is attached. Here, another benzene ring here, carboxylic and methoxy group is attached. Here. If you see here, deoxyanisoene. Here, the methoxy group and ethyl group is CH2 is attached here. Here, same as it is, there is no change in the structure. In the presence of the ethyl iodide, C2H5I is the ethyl iodide. This is a sodium ethoxide. We will get the intermediate compound. So here, what will happen is, here in this position, the CH2, here one of the hydrogen will get eliminated and here C2H5 will get attached. Next, in presence of phenyl magnesium iodide, C2H5MgI is phenyl magnesium iodide, we will get another intermediate compound. So here what will happen here? For the carbon atom here, the ethyl group and one of the hydroxyl group is attached. So next, in presence of the phosphorus tribromide and the water molecule has been eliminated. See here, phosphorus tribromide and water molecule will get eliminated to get another intermediate compound. Here this true structure has been bonded with double bond, attached with the double bond. See here, attached with the double bond, and here water molecule will get eliminated to form the intermediate. Next, in presence of the ethanolic potassium hydroxide, we will get diethyl stilbestrol. I will explain it again. The starting material is 4-hydroxybenzaldehyde. So two molecules of 4-methoxy benzaldehyde. In presence of potassium cyanide, we will get anisoene. So this two molecules here are the benzaldehyde. So here, in presence of the tin chloride, we will get deoxyanisoene. When deoxyanisoene is reacted in presence of the ethyl iodide and sodium ethoxide, we will get the intermediate compound. So here, in place of the CH2, one of the hydrogen will be eliminated, and here the ethyl group has been attached. So in presence of phenyl magnesium iodide, we will get the another intermediate compound. So here, for the carbon atom, ethyl group and hydroxyl group is attached. Next, in presence of phosphorus tribromide, the water molecule will get eliminated, means it undergoes the dehydration process. We will get another intermediate compound. So these two compounds will get attached by using the double bond. Next, in presence of ethanolic potassium hydroxide, we will get diethyl stilbestrol. So here the methoxy groups are there, no? COCH3 and OCH3 has been replaced with the hydroxyl group. So this is the synthesis, that is the DOTS method. Next method from anithiol. The starting material is the anithiol. Here two molecules of the anithiol in the presence of hydrogen bromide. So we will get the anithiol hydrobromide. So here, for the carbon atom, here two double bonds are there, no? This double bond has been cut. and this bond has been converted here one of the hydrogen, and here from the hydrogen bromide one of the bromide is attached here and another hydrogen is attached here to form CH2. So in presence of sodium amide and liquid ammonia we will get intermediate compound, means these two compounds, means these two structures has been attached by using the double bond. See here, here two molecules are said known. Here two molecules has been attached by using the double bond, and in presence of alkali we will get the diethyl stilbestrol. So here the methoxy group has been replaced with the hydroxyl group. So this is the synthesis from the anthiol. I will repeat it again. Here two molecules of the anthiol we are taking in the presence of the hydrogen bromide. So what we will get? Anthiol hydrobromide. Here one of the double bond will get broken down and it is converted to the hydrogen. And here this bromide is attached here and this hydrogen bond is attached here. And next, in presence of sodium amide and liquid ammonia, here two molecules have said no. Two molecules has been attached by using the double bond. In presence of the alkali, here the methoxy group is replaced with the hydroxide to get the diethyl stilbestrol. So this is the synthesis. Next, progesterone. Next is progesterone. The progesterone means favoring for the pregnancy, means it is used, it is responsible for getting the pregnancy, and these are the substances in the corpus luteum which converts the estrogen primer endometrium to secretory endometrium which maintains the pregnancy. So this is the main hormone used to maintain the pregnancy in the female. So this was isolated from the corpus luteum, adrenal cortex, placenta and the testes. So this is the structure and this is the IUPAC name of the progesterone, that is 17-acetyl 10,13-dimethyl 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, and 17 dodecahydrocyclopentaphenanthrene 3-ol. I will repeat it again. 17-acetyl 10,13-dimethyl 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, and 17 dodecahydrocyclopentaphenanthrene 3-ol. So if you see here, this is the phenanthrene structure. 6-3-6 numbered ring is the phenanthrene structure. One cyclopentane is there. Here in the third position oxygen, in 17th position acetyl group, in 10th and 13th position methyl groups are there. How many? 2. So it is dimethyl. So it is 17-acetyl 10,13-dimethyl dodecahydrocyclopentaphenanthrene 3-ol. So this is the structure and IUPAC name of the progesterone. Next, synthesis. The starting material is cholesterol. When it is reacted, undergoes reaction in the presence of bromine and in presence of the bromine and acetic anhydrous, we will get this intermediate compound. Here in the 5th and the 6th position, two bromines are attached. So next, in presence of the acetic acid, zinc, chromium trioxide, and acetic acid, we will get this compound, that is dehydroepinarosterone. So if you see the structure here, the side chain undergoes the cleavage and also the bromine will get eliminated. And here in the 17th position, the oxygen group is attached. So next, in presence of potassium cyanide and acetic anhydrous, we will get intermediate compound. So here in the third position, here hydroxyl group is there. So in place of hydroxyl group, the acetic anhydrous will get attached. And here in the 17th position, the hydroxyl group and cyanide group is attached. Next, in presence of the phosphorus trichloride in pyridine at 150 degrees centigrade. So we have to heat to the 150 degrees centigrade. We will get another intermediate compound. Here the hydroxyl group will get eliminated. See here in the 17th position, this hydroxyl group will get eliminated. Next, in presence of methyl magnesium bromide, we will get the intermediate compound. Here in the 17th position, the cyanide is removed. In place of the cyanide, the acetic anhydrous will get attached. Next, when it undergoes the hydrolysis process, we will get pregnenolone. So here in the third position, here acetyl group is there. So in place of acetyl group, the hydroxyl group is replaced. Next, when it undergoes the oxidation process, we will get progesterone. So here one of the hydrogen is eliminated and it is replaced with the double bond. So this is the synthesis of the progesterone. I will repeat it again. The starting material is the cholesterol. In presence of acetic anhydrous and bromide, here in the 5th and the 6th position, the bromine is attached to get the intermediate compound. In presence of chromium trioxide, acetic acid and zinc, we will get dihydroepandrosterone. So here the side chain undergoes the cleavage in 17th position. It is replaced with the oxygen atom. In presence of acetic anhydrous and potassium cyanide, here what will happen in the 3rd position, hydroxyl group is replaced with acetic anhydrous, and here in the 17th position, hydroxyl group and cyanide group is attached. Next, phosphorus chloride in pyrimidine, how to heat at the 150 degrees centigrade to get the another in the intermediate product. Here the hydroxyl group is eliminated. Next, in presence of methyl magnesium bromide, CH3MgBr is methyl magnesium bromide, we will get another intermediate compound. Here the cyanide group is eliminated. In place of the cyanide, the acetic anhydrous group is attached. When it undergoes the hydrolysis process, we will get pregnenolone. Here in the 3rd position, the acetic anhydrous group is replaced with the hydroxyl group. When it undergoes the oxidation, here the hydroxyl group is replaced with the oxygen group to get the progesterone. So this is the synthesis of the progesterone. And these are the references books to be followed for the steroids. Thank you.